Hey guys and girls, welcome back to another edition of Let's Beat the Snot Out Of. Now today we are going to beat the snot out of a vehicle that's a little bit larger than a normal trail truck. I still consider it a trail truck, but it's a little bit larger. So we're going to head into the death roads today. Now the vehicle we're going to beat the snot out of, now I've got to get the name right, it's Lucas Z98, and it's a combo between Yarrick, I can't remember the last numbers on that guy's name, Yarrick, Lucas, and another guy called Janos. It's the LGS Fenneck. Now, to their credit, I have seen photos of the real deal, and their LGS Fenneck actually looks better than the thing in real life. The standard LGS Fenneck actually has a single pair of headlights. These guys have added duals, and it just looks heaps better. As I said, the real one in real life only has a single headlight, not duals. This thing looks great. I mean, look at the details on it. It's got, you know, what are these, tear gas or mortar canisters on the back. It's got a little aerial mount here. It's got three hatches on it, and one of them's occupied by what looks like a turret. It looks brilliant. As I said, if you actually looked at this thing and the real-life LGS Fenneck, this is a much better vehicle. Okay. So let's back her up. We'll discuss a couple of the options you get. Okay. You get the option to add the LGS add-ons, which basically adds 3 garage points, 400 repair points. You get the option to add in a driver who sits in the middle. Yes, this thing is like a McLaren F1. You sit in the middle. You also get the option to add a garage trailer. So you could use this vehicle to go and unlock a garage if you desire. Now, you get 1,500 points worth of damage. You get 600 litres of onboard fuel. And you get an option for all-wheel drive only. You can't change the diff lock. It's always on. It's rear-wheel drive to begin with, but with the option of all-wheel drive. Now, there's one thing I will say about this thing, is it's low, large, and wide. Ouch. As I said, it's low, large, and wide. It takes a little bit of getting used to. Now, I will say this straight up. The default, there's no option for tyres on it, but the default tyres are actually pretty good. The only area that this truck really struggles with is deep, deep mud and rocks. That's it. Everything else it seems to handle pretty easy. Shallow mud doesn't seem to be a problem. The only other thing I will mention is you get a great third-person camera. It's brilliant. If you can get used to driving on the inside of this in the central position, you'll be fine. Yep, pretty good there. The only boggle I have with this is because of its size, the camera constantly wants to zoom in on it, and it makes it really annoying. So I've got the camera fully zoomed out now, but every time we go through a major elevation change, the camera will zoom in on this truck's booty and make it really hard to drive. Oh, there we go. See what I mean? Just driving along, next thing it zooms in on its booty. So you're constantly having to find yourself adjusting the camera. And again. I want out, not in. So yeah, it constantly zooms in on the truck's behind. Now, it does have limited suspension travel, but to tell you the truth, it doesn't seem to stop this truck at all. It just seems to fly across trails. See, there we go, we're zoomed in again. I don't want to be zoomed in that close. So every so often the camera just zooms in on that big end booty, and that's it. You gotta constantly readjust. Now we're just going through some of the trail here. There we go, did it again. Stop it. I wish we could just lock cameras into distances. Not necessary positions, but distances. Constantly going to be using your scroll wheel to zoom the mouse at the camera out. Now, high water levels are equal to the hatches on the roof. However, I will say, if you get water up to here on the back, it does take, start taking damage. I'll give you a quick demonstration of that by just driving down this little bit of the river. It'll get deep real quick in a second. Oh, stop with the camera zoom already. So there you go, your dangerous water level is about here on the back. Now let's see if I can get back out. I might have left it too late. Ah! Now I'm starting to take damage. Back her up. Let's see if I can drive her out. See, there we go. I took water damage because the water went too far over the back end. Oh, don't slide down there. That's annoying, the camera keeps zooming in. Okay, now the thing is, we get plenty of winch points. There's four on the front, there's five on the back. So we are not left wanting four winch points. Plenty of winch points. Oh, come on, climb. Get up there. Okay. Well, we got up that bit. Let's keep going. See the camera? Ah, oh, it just annoys me. It just zooms in on that the Fenneck rim end constantly. Hard to drive. Now if we lose it here, it's game over. Now you can see how wide this thing is judged by the size of the trail. Now here comes the difficult section here, and as I said, even with limited suspension travel, it just dominates that section. Absolutely dominates it. Go. See, back behind the booty again. Hey. Sounds like there's a couple of loose marbles in that diesel engine. Anyway, this truck has great details. Its capabilities are actually beyond what it looks. The only place, as I said, this thing will really struggle in is rock crawling and deep, deep mud. Due to its kind of like relatively low ground clearance, it can belly out a lot faster than some other trucks. I just love the details on it. It's beautiful. I like the fact that it actually looks better and more streamlined than the real thing. I gotta give this a rating of download it. Because some of you might like it, some of you might not. Some of you might have a little difficulty with the size of it. But you could use this as a rescue vehicle. It's got a lot of recovery points, a lot of winch points. As I said, you just saw it on death roads and it didn't have much of an issue at all. You've seen some of my other trail trucks struggle on death roads. This didn't seem to have any problems at all. Okay, yeah, it's a little low, a little wide, a little large. But apart from that, it's a great truck. Alrighty, guys. So, yeah, as I said, give it a download. Give it a try. See how you go. You might like it. You might not. Alrighty, guys. Until next time, when we beat the snot out of something else, see ya.